I would like to welcome everyone to our last Advent Praying with the Sisters. And this is an Nuns Life Ministry. So we are delighted that you took time to surf across in Facebook and stop and pray with us for a little bit. We're not here real long, so it's worth your time. And we appreciate anybody who stops and share the word. Invite your friends to join us as well. I'm Sister Julie Myers. I'm a part of the Nuns Life Ministry team. And I would like to invite Sister Michelle, if you'd introduce yourself as well.
Sure. Thank you, Sister Julie. My name is Sister Michelle Fisher. I am a sister of the Holy Family of Nazareth and currently living in St. Joseph the Worker House of Discernment in Richardson, Texas. It's great to be with you.
Thank you.
And I'm Sister Maxine of A Nun's Life.
And I'm Kelly Zladek with A Nun's Life.
And this is us. So for our prayer, we will share the psalm from today as well as the gospel. And Sister Michelle will then share a reflection based on the readings. And then we'll have a chance to share a prayer together, any intercessory prayer, prayers of thanksgiving. And we do invite you to type those in the comment section, and we will read those aloud as we see them. Sometimes they move fast, we don't catch all of them, but we'll do our best to read your prayers aloud so that we can all share in that petition with you. And then we'll bring a little closure and have a chit chat so we can find out a little bit more about Sister Michelle. So we'll do that at the end of our prayer.
All right. Tonight, as we begin our prayer, let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God. God of grace, we open our hearts, minds, and souls to you this evening. Come be with us, inspire us, and lead us in our time together. In Christ's name, amen.
Amen.
Our reading is from the Psalms. Sing out your joy to God, you who love justice. Praise is fitting for loyal hearts.
Praise God with the harp and play music with a 10-stringed lyre.
Sing God a new song. Play with all your skill and with shouts of joy.
But your own plan will stand firm forever, the designs of your heart from age to age.
Happy is the nation whose God is God. Happy the people you choose as your own inheritance.
And so we wait for God, our help and our shield.
For in you our hearts find joy. We trust in your holy name.
Glory to you, source of all goodness, eternal word and Holy Spirit.
As in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Our reading is from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 1, verses 39 to 45. Within a few days, Mary set out and hurried to the hill country, to a town of Judah, where she entered Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. As soon as Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. In a loud voice, she exclaimed, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. But why am I so favored that the mother of the Messiah should come to me? The moment your greeting reached my ears, the child in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed is she who believed that what our God said to her would be accomplished." The word of God. So thank you again for this invite to share the word and reflect on that. You might say I'm a small town kid. I grew up in a don't blink or you'll miss it little town, Port Clinton, Pennsylvania, nestled along the Blue Mountains and the Schuylkill Water Gap. Population 300, including cats, dogs, bears, and deer. For whatever it's worth, it was my little version of paradise. Knowing almost everyone in the town made it impossible to convince your parents that you were not the culprit of whatever it was you might have been accused of. But on the other hand, it gave you endless adventures with neighbors and stories that 50 years later still get retold. As we reflect this evening on the beautiful gospel capturing the visitation of Mary and Elizabeth, in my heart, I went back to my small town roots. One of my daily chores after I was old enough to ride across town on my bike was to go to the post office to pick up the mail. It was about a mile from our home on the north side of town. Getting there involved passing by almost the entire town with lots of neighbors to say hello to, dogs and cats to pet, front porches to be visited, and old folks to be checked on. A 2 mile, 20 minute tour of duty typically lasted anywhere from 2 to 3 hours as I stopped to make many visitations along the way. These little daily encounters opened up a space in my heart for others that I believe was how the seeds of my own religious vocation began to grow. Something in me felt this budding reverence for those that I encountered, and each in their own way contributed beautiful threads to the weaving that has become my life. Now I can say the Christ in me recognized the Christ in them, and the Spirit was moving, dancing, and shining among us, just as it did years ago between Mary and Elizabeth and their unborn babies. The gospel tells us that Mary went with haste to the hill country to see her cousin Elizabeth. Mary, after having the incredible encounter with the archangel Gabriel, needed time for pondering, questioning, breathing in silence, and living into the vulnerability of her consent. But then there was the stirring in her gut that urged her to action. There's a time for everything. And now was the time for movement, for decisiveness. We too often get an intuition that God is stirring in our inmost being. And we need to pay attention to it. We need to follow it, as did Mary. And to use the prayer of 2 feet to open the way for God, to make a path where there's no path. When I recall those blessed days from my childhood, I imagine that this might have been the way Mary and Elizabeth met one another in that tender yet powerful scene from the Gospel of St. Luke. Kindred spirits, kinswomen who allowed themselves to be instruments. Mary and Elizabeth, women of the promise, partners in an unfolding incarnation, birthing a future that would change the world forever. The work of incarnation can't be contained in a single historical birth in Bethlehem over 2,000 years ago. The work of incarnation is here, is now, is unfolding within you and within me, and within the lives of every soul in creation, as the power of God at work in the universe propels us into action, collaborators in this great and expanding work, the reign of God that is at hand, that is within, and that is yet to be fulfilled. Mary and Elizabeth, your generosity in cooperating with God's will initiated the events of the New Testament. May we be equally generous in cooperating with God's plans for our lives, knowing the beginning, but not the end, lighting a fire that warms the lives of unknown others. So go, make haste, meet the Christ in one another. Amen.
And so now we invite you to share any prayers of petition, prayers of intention that you would like to have us read aloud, and we will do so. Just type them in the comment section. And Sister Michelle, Sister Max and Kelly, if you have any prayers that you would like to share, I invite you to do that now.
Sister Michelle, thank you for that beautiful reflection. Every time I read this reading, I can't help but think back when I was pregnant with my first child and even my second, the joy of like sharing the news with my family and my extended family. Like there's just something about it. There's just like this overabundance of joy that I felt. And then when I shared the news that they felt, and just, there's just something there. So I always think of that when I read this story, and just how Mary and Elizabeth must have felt too, like the excitement and the joy. And so it's a great story.
Yes.
I like reading it. So
thank you. I was also thinking during this time of COVID, you know, how hungry we all are for the human touch. And I imagine like all the versions of the visitation of just Mary and Elizabeth just holding each other and hugging each other and like running toward each other. And now it's like, well, hold on, don't get too close. And so I thought of all the tender moments in the gospel that this is such a challenge. And even tonight, when I think of praying for those individuals, the people who are in hospitals and suffering from COVID and their families who can't physically be there just to hold their hand or tell them it's going to be okay. God bless the frontline workers and the people in the hospitals that have tried to bring them comfort and peace during that time of crisis. I especially want to lift up a deacon from our parish who is very ill right now and in need of prayers. But, you know, may these visitation moments that we shared in the past, maybe they still live in us in a way that can bring that comfort at this time when we can't have the human touch and when we can't reach out physically to one another.
Mm-hmm. And that promise of new life is always something of great hope. And I think about how, you know, tonight is the night where there's supposed to be the conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn, you know, the star of Bethlehem, so to say. And I think of people who are tonight looking up at that star and at the stars and thinking, you know, what will the new year bring? You know, this is the first time in 800 years this has happened again. So what will the next, maybe not 800 years be, what will the next year be? What hope do I feel as I gaze, you know, gaze to the heavens? So I, you know, I keep in my prayer everybody who has got that hope-filled spirit in the midst of everything that our world is going through today, who's got that hope-filled spirit, knowing that God will take care of things.
I'd like to pray for folks out there who are discerning their vocation, whether it's a religious vocation, a vocation to marriage, a single vocation, that God would inspire them to know when is the time to make haste and be decisive in that discernment, because it can be difficult and, you know, it's painful and challenging. And at the same time, when you get to that point of liberation, it's fantastic to be able to make that decisive step and to put some haste in your step. And move forward. So for all those who are out there thinking about what life is bringing and what they should be doing and looking toward in their own lives, may the Spirit come and inspire.
Speaking of people making haste, I was driving, had to do an errand, and I drove past the mall of all places today. And even in the midst of COVID, there was a huge amount of traffic. I'm sure it was people making haste to get the last of their Christmas presents. So I pray for all those people who are out there trying to get a special gift for their loved ones, that they may be safe and keep others safe in the process of that.
I want to pray for the teachers and students that are on break. I know my husband and my daughter are both on their winter break. So prayers that they find the next 2-3 weeks, however long their break is, it's relaxing and rejuvenating and just peaceful for them. I know it's been a hard semester for so many. So I hope that this break is truly a break for all of them.
I'd like to pray for all those who are bringing Christmas joy to others, especially through the gift of music and song. I've seen so many beautiful performances online, people really using their creativity to produce beautiful, beautiful prayer and liturgy and music. A shout out to our Nazareth Academy High School in Philadelphia. The chorale and the chorus last night did a candlelight service, and it was just so touching and heartwarming. So kudos to you young ladies and all, everybody out there who's willing to share their joy in this time of sorrow for a lot of people.
Jen offers a prayer of thanksgiving for those who are able to be present with and those who make a way to be present with our life. So the gift of presence in people's lives is so important, especially as we said this time.
And Denise offers prayers for the gift of life for Janice G on her birthday. So first of all, happy birthday, Janice G. And Denise says she has been a light for so many people. May God bless her abundantly. So again, we send our birthday greetings along with yours, Denise, to Janice.
Dorothy asked for prayers for Marissa, who recently lost her hearing. Can't even imagine. We definitely lift Marissa up and pray for her and her family and friends. And so we'll hold her in our hearts, definitely. Thank you, Dorothy.
And Sister Denise offers a prayer for healing for so many of her extended family who have COVID. And I know a lot of us, our families, we keep hearing the news that somebody has COVID and somebody else has COVID. And if it's not in our families, it's in our circle of friends. And so we just extend our good and healthy energy to them from that social distancing hug that we can give, and just ask God's blessing and healing and recovery for them.
I asked for prayers for my aunt again. She is still in the hospital now. It's been 4 weeks. Her family has not been able to see her in 4 weeks, so I can't even imagine how that's been for all of them. So just prayers for her that she finds strength, the doctors figure out what's going on, and that she can get out of the hospital soon. So prayers for that.
As winter continues to set in, we also keep in our prayers everyone who has no permanent home. We pray for their safety on these cold evenings. We pray that they may find a warm shelter and companionship, a good meal, and they may know what it is to be part of a community, however fleeting that might be.
Would like to pray for all the people who struggle with addiction with drugs and alcohol and the many, many ways we can be challenged by addiction. Pray for them that they're able to find the strength and the courage within themselves to overcome, to be stronger than that weakness that is a part of them, and to reach out for help when they can't do it alone, so that they know they're not alone in this very trying, dark time.
I'd like to lift up our Holy Father, Pope Francis, especially in his many attempts to bring unity to our world. We are in the midst of reading Fratelli Tutti in our local community and just sharing and pondering on all the deeper meanings and the invitations from God that are present in that letter. And we ask the Lord to, give him strength and zeal. He has so much zeal for the kingdom that we'll be able to follow suit and follow his example, both in big and small ways, beginning with within our own homes, in our own families and communities.
Jennifer prays for those who are high risk, who are isolated from their loved ones this holiday season, and what a tough challenge that is to be away when you're most in need of your family, your companions. So we hold them up and ask God's blessing in very special ways upon them.
I'd like to offer up a special prayer of thanksgiving for all of our friends and supporters of the ministry. We couldn't do this without them, so we are very grateful, and thank you for all the people that support us and join us on nights like this. So thank you.
Right now, our congregation is in the midst of our novena for the Feast of the Holy Family, our congregational feast. And so I'd like to remember all the intentions that people have been asking during that novena, and for all the families of the world.
And Kelly asks for prayers for clergy having to make tough decisions. And I know that they face many difficult decisions throughout the years and throughout these days. So we hold a clergy in our prayer and all people who find themselves in that kind of a position, especially at this time of year, of having to make the difficult decisions. We pray that they find the strength to do and to decide what they believe is right in their hearts.
Marcia, you're never too late. Thank you for joining us. Marcia offers a prayer for her 14-year-old granddaughter who is seriously depressed and is in the hospital right now, just really struggling with depression. So Marcia, we hold her up in our prayers. Just pray that she's able to have the courage to believe in herself and to see hope, to experience that gift of hope, especially now during Christmas. It's a gift, and sometimes it's a miracle that comes to those who are most in need of that gift. So we do hold her, and we'll remember her in our prayers.
We lift up all the prayers tonight that were either spoken or written, and especially the ones that we hold deep in our hearts tonight. And I just like to close with a simple prayer. Gracious God, we thank you for this day and for the blessing that it has been to join with so many people in prayer over these last 4 weeks. May the things that you reveal to us and the thoughts that we have shared dwell in our hearts and stir us to action. Help us to trust in the relationships in our lives that show us your love and your lasting peace. And help us to walk in that love during these final days of Advent as we wait and prepare for Christ's coming. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for being with us. Sister Michelle, it was great having you and sharing your reflection. Very grateful for your words and for your message. And I'm sure our audience appreciates the thoughts that you've shared so that they can continue to ponder your message in their prayer. I don't know if everybody knows you real well. I know you are very involved in vocation ministry here in Illinois. And you're a big part of NRVC for quite a while. And you were on one of our very first Mother House Road Trip podcasts, which was what, 7, 8 years ago, I think.
Yeah, I think it was 2013 or 2014.
August 2013.
Oh, I was right.
Yep, you were our second pod. You were on our second ever one. Mother House Road Trip.
That was really great. I'm still involved in a little bit of vocation work. I was vocation director for our province from 2006 until 2013, 2014. And then I was in community leadership for a while. That took me out to Chicago, to Des Plaines. And when I finished that term, I was invited to enter formation work. So our sisters, through the generosity of a wonderful parish here in Richardson, Texas, we were able to open a house of discernment, something that we had been hoping for at least more than 5 years, trying to get it off the ground. And the people at St. Paul the Apostle Parish and the pastor welcomed us last year. They prepared the house for us. It was a wonderful experience and continues to be. And so we wanted to have a place where young women could come and just be with us. You know, the women that we've had so far are discerning religious life in our congregation. But it can certainly go beyond that. We had a house full last year. We had 3 professed sisters and 4 affiliates living with us.
Wow.
So, and we have a capacity for 7. We had 7. So, and in the middle of that, COVID hit. So that was an adventure. This year, we're very pleased to have 1 affiliate with us. We had some others that we thought might be here, but with COVID, it hadn't materialized. So maybe next year. But what a joy it has been. And Katie's our affiliate. She was actually working our Holy Family Novena tonight. So she's a joy to be with. But to be able to journey with young women first in their vocations, you know, early vocation ministry, and then as they begin formation, it's a blessing and a joy. Mm-hmm.
Now, how long can they stay at the house before, say, they move on, or is there a period of time that they get?
Yeah, well, affiliacy could be anywhere from 6 months to 2 years. And it seems like almost a year. Maybe if they come in September, usually by June or July, they're ready to move on one way or the other. But we're still new at this. So.
And do you all take turns cooking?
Yes,
or
we do.
Is there? Do you? Okay.
Yes.
Do you have a favorite dish that you make?
Oh, many.
What are you best at cooking? What's your, like, people really want this one meal you make?
Oh, I don't know. I love to make Thanksgiving dinner.
Do you really?
Last year we had a guest from Philadelphia, somebody who knew us. I wanted to come visit us. We had a lot of guests last year before COVID. And so we cooked a Thanksgiving dinner. And he, in fact, just yesterday, he sent pictures saying that was the best meal I had. So, but we have all kinds. Last year we had a Vietnamese affiliate. And so she taught us how to make spring rolls and all kinds of really great dishes. And we have a little Mexican dishes this year. So it's, variety is the spice of life. We're having some Polish tomorrow for our Christmas. One of our sisters is from Poland. And so we have lots to learn from each other. It's always an adventure.
Multicultural event going on in the kitchen. That's fun.
You got it. In fact, I looked at a picture from our dinner plate from last Christmas and I said, holy moly, we had tamales, we had spring rolls. But it was fun. Good adventure.
That's great.
Thank you. Yeah. So are you enjoying Texas from the cold Midwest time?
Yes. Yeah. And we didn't even have too bad of a summer this year. I was ready for it to be like in the hundreds. And it wasn't bad. It wasn't bad. But the parish is lovely. The people are great. There's always some activity going on. So it's great to be here.
It's always good to be a part of a parish.
Yeah. I haven't lived with the family for so long. Because I was living in our provincialate, and before that I lived in Philadelphia in a hospital convent. So my favorite thing, I have to be truthful, is Halloween, because we actually had trick-or-treaters at our door.
Did you dress up? Did you dress up to pass out candy or no?
Well, we carved pumpkins, so we had our pumpkins out on the porch.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, this year we had masks on, so but no, it was those special little touches. Mm-hmm. That, and a lot of people are outside walking now, walking babies and dogs, and so it's great to see all that activity in the neighborhood.
Fun.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Yes, it has been.
Well, it was a delight having you, and it's good seeing you again.
Thank you.
We used to connect in vocation work, so.
Well, I still work with Kava out in Chicago.
Long distance
board membership, so Sister Lavina still reels me in, but it's a joy. Okay. It was a joy to connect with you all too, and you got my prayers and support. And for all those out there in Facebook land, it's been a pleasure to be with you.
And Sister Michelle, if we could get a copy of that beautiful reflection you gave, we would love to be able to post that on our website so that people can go back and read it.
Will do.
Okay, wonderful. Thank you.
Lucky I actually wrote this one down. Although I have to tell you, what I actually gave you was not what was written down at 3 o'clock this afternoon. So.
Oh, whew. You might have to listen and type.
It was beautiful. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yes, thank you very much.
Yeah. Well, wish you all a blessed Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you and a beautiful, bright new year. We gotta pray for happiness and hope beyond COVID.
Amen. We'll pray for everybody's families as we finish up our novena. So.
All right.
Great.
Well, to you, our online audience, we thank you. We wish you a very Merry Christmas and a blessed New Year. Mm-hmm. Take care and keep in touch. Keep visiting our website. Good night.
Good night.